finished the league off stream that I started on Monday after the power outage. We went 4-1. So let's see, what did I actually play against? Round 1, Yawgmoth, GB, lose 1-1. Round 2, Jonsaga, 1-1. Round 3, Rakdos, 1-1. Round 4, Grixis Shadow, loss. Hammer Time, 1-1. So, I kind of think, given where the metagame is going, you want to play 4 Veil of Summer. It's just really good versus the Rakdos shells or the Grixis shells. And I think it's fine versus Aureus, of course, but Teferi 3 is obviously a problem. And it's sort of fine in the mirror, it's like high variance. So that's my thought on that card. You know, kind of a good card to have access to a lot of, especially versus Rakdos and Grixis, and less so versus the other decks I listed. So yeah, that's the 4 Veils. I've moved a Knight of Autumn to the main. I just moved some cards around, pretty much. Still think I might play 1 Lightning Bolt. I kind of don't like Abundant Harvest. Does anyone have any strong opinions on Abundant Harvest? Like, anyone? Because, you know, it's like... Abundant Harvest sucks. I'm inclined to agree, actually. Anyone else have any opinions? Exactly mediocre. Yeah, that's how I feel about it too. I had one wandering mine in on Monday as well. The one of. So, Abundant Harvest, I think to view it as a one of is not quite correct. It's just a card you can play before turn 3 to pick up with Eternal Witness. Harvest a second path? I'm not about that. I don't even really love the first path that much, but I think you have to just play a fifth Solitude. Abundant Harvest is like the fifth Abundant Growth, I guess, sort of, in a weird way, but... Also, I cut Reflecting Pool. That card sucks. Like, I don't know why other people have it. I think it's kind of a scam. Like, there's just so many hands where you draw a Reflecting Pool, and it's just worse than a fetch land most of the time. Definitely not the fifth Abundant Growth. Obviously, I'm like, I wasn't being literal there, so if you're gonna take it literally, Oath of Nissa? No, I want something to pick up with Eternal Witness, John. Like, this is like actually a key core of the deck, in my opinion. Oath of Nissa is definitely much better with cards. Like, Oath of Nissa is good with Teferi 3. And Oath of Nissa is also good with Philidor Guardian. Well, I wasn't really being sarcastic. It's just that it falls on the same spot of the mana curve and it has the word abundant in it. And it kind of does something that cycles, so I don't know what you want from me. Like, you know, I literally don't know what you want from me there. There are kind of a lot of lands in this deck that don't cast Counterspell. Yeah. And there's 4 Abundant Growths. Like, I don't know, Boland. I don't think it's, like, an issue, because... I think... Counterspell is so good in the scenarios you get into. Like, people say that you don't e-witness Counterspell something again, but I found that you actually do that a lot. Like, it's just... how do I put it? Yeah, Counterspell is a good late game card. It's also a good card versus some of your bad matchups. Oh, that's the card I wanted to play. I want to play 1 Obsidian Charmaw. What am I going to cut? What am I allowed to cut for one charm off? Veil? Well, I want four veils because of the rise of Rakdos and Grixis. So those are like different matchups. I think I might cut an Aether Gust. Type card in front of it. Exclamation card. Okay, BJC, if you're new to this stream, I would like a reason why you think I should cut those cards. Now I'm trying to think through all of the reasons. Abundant Growth makes all of our lands counterspell. Yeah. Cut Yorion, but keep the 80 card deck. I'm probably not going to do that. That seems really bad. Need another sideboard slot. Nice troll. All right. Personally, I think I'm going to cut the Knight of Autumn from the sideboard because I already have a Knight of Autumn in the main deck, and I'm not sure the second adds a lot. Where the first is like the best copy because of two Elodomri's Call, in my opinion. So I actually think I'm going to cut Knight of Autumn. Well, BJC, I gave a reason and you didn't. Like, you just said a bunch of words. So, that's... I mean... On this stream, when people say stuff, I'm not looking just for an answer. I really need a reason. Like, you need a well-reasoned-out reason to do things, in my opinion. Alright. What do I add missing cards? Did they break that feature? What am I missing? Foothill is in a Veil of Summer. Okay. Guess we will try those cards. Math and Logic Stream. Yes, exactly that. Alright. I'm going to go get cards from my sponsor card hoarder. And if you want to check them out, feel free to use that referral link and whatever you get from them. Some part of it helps me out, so, you know, just consider that. One in Foothills, one in Veil of Summer. Dovin's Veto is my hate card for Belcher. As is Aethergust secretly. Blossoming Calm is fine versus a Belcher activation. Yeah, it's literally for a Belcher activation, but it's not... not what you want. Got some cards. Wait, where are the cards? Where did it go? Chat, where did it go? That's where it went. Oh, I need another Veil of Summer. Whoops. For some reason I only put in one. Alright. Well, guess I'll put in one less request. I'm a goof. Am I a doof or a goof? Yeah, Time Warp is, like, overkill, I think. It's mostly because I think Time Warp sucks versus all of these Rakdos slash Grixis-style decks Poland. If there were less of those and more, like, Tron or Amulet, I would probably have the Time Warp back in my deck. Alright, so we're waiting for the last Veil of Summer, and then we'll be ready to rebattle and hope my power doesn't go out this time. On Monday, I suffered a windstorm, which KO'd my power. But, you know, that can happen sometimes. Alright, what's today? Today's the 8th. I'm gonna get this up on Cardboard Live. Again, if you're new to the stream, thanks for being here. If you want to support it, check for that Twitch Prime sub. Hit that follow button. Following is free to do, at least. December 8th, 2021, Orsi, Orion, Moneyball, Aldomeri's Call, V2. V2 might be a stretch, but V1 point, whatever, is probably more accurate. Miracles are expensive now? Not surprising. Alright, can someone tell me if the decklist is updated? Anyways, we'll start a prediction for our first league match. Feel free to gamble some channel points on the outcome of this match. Looks good? Alright, cool. Oh, I will be playing this on Saturday, I think. 2 days. 10 hours. But not right now. Am I going to do the PAX thing? Probably not. I don't even know what that is, really. What's up, Army of Thalia? Hiya, Jarvin. God damn it. Saying, calling me Jarvin? You actually do hate to see it. Alright, is this the right list? Yeah. Submit. Well, I thought you were making a TFT joke because Jarvin was a unit in other sets. Alright. Going for the EQ combo. What's the EQ combo? I've never actually played League itself. I played Dota way back when it was on Warcraft as a mod. Like as a... how do I put it? Oh, like, it was like a custom game within Warcraft. I didn't play League, like, basically whatsoever. I also remember Aeon of Strife, which was within Warcraft 3 as well. Oh, it's kind of sick. So you just place a flag and then you hit Q and stun everyone, right? Sounds like very skillful to use, very difficult to use it. Everyone's scared of me, chat. Where are all of my opponents? What is modern? Format that goes from 8th edition until now. Alright, opponent has no companion. One lander with abundant growth. I think I usually mulligan these. It's like kind of unsafe. Alright, well, this is also kind of unsafe, but I'm gonna keep. This song is a banger. This play track is just all bangers. Alright. I'll sneak in a tap land here. I might end up regretting playing that, obviously, but I think generally I'm okay just playing it and having the ability to cycle. Or not having the ability to cycle. I think when a Spreading sees that. Don't really want to just witness back like a fetch. Like, I'm kind of flooded. It's fine. Spreading Seas my forest? Yeah. It just isn't human. I agree with you that maybe it's a little bit centrified or centric to Modern Horizons 1, Modern Horizons 2. Because those are really powerful sets. That being said, I think the gameplay is generally pretty good. I do agree the cost of entry is really high. And like, if you don't have those cards, it kind of sucks. Alright, well, they're going to get obliterated. If you Spreading Seas that, like, the game kind of ends on the spot. Because they have two islands. It kind of looks like they're actually Ponza, so I'm going to fetch some basics, so. But yeah, this is just brutal. Like, this will get island, this will get plains. Yo, what's up, Dom? How are you doing? Yeah, my opponent didn't want to play after I double stone rained them. Alright, well, they're a red-green deck, so this is guaranteed to be good. I'm gonna cut this, and probably cut... Wait, I thought I cut the Abundant Harvest. Oh my god. I didn't cut the Abundant Harvest? Ah, shit. Oh well. I'm already up a game. I'm not dropping. Yeah, actually, Janky, it does count as double Stern Rain. Funny you bring that up. I'll actually cut the Harvest on the draw, I think. You could make a case for Purge, but I don't want to side that in until I know for sure. Run brought back? Yeah, I've seen that version. I don't really love it. Obviously, it does have some strengths, but I don't think putting another 4-drop into these decks really improves them on average. That's why I don't do that. But you could... I'm talking about Showdown of the Skull specifically. I guess I'll keep. This is not, like, the most insane, but... It's going to 5? Sheesh. This can get blue, white, red. This can get plains, and this is forest, so. Or maybe I should play around Blood Moon by playing the Heath first. Yeah, probably should. And just see what they do. Oh, interesting. Okay. I mean, Brought Back is a pretty powerful card, I'm not gonna lie. Tireless Tracker. Okay. Not expecting that. Alright. Hand's a little bit clunky, but whatever. It'll probably work itself out. I don't need to play the run here. It'll just die if I play run here, so... I think I'm just gonna fetch a bunch of basics. Yeah, it looks like red-green midrange from 2 years ago, so... I'm just trying to play around Blood Moon, if possible. Just want to buy some time. Yeah, no reason not to have Obosh yet, but they probably have like Blood Raid Elf or some nonsense. This song's a banger too. Alright, this is not the best counterspell, but you know, that's fine. There's my Teferi. I'm fine with that. It was like a renewed faith. That's fine. Like, literally don't care about that now. In fact, like, it kind of helps me. This is why I fetched all basics, by the way. I just knew. I knew. And we're just doing it. We're dimmadonna doing it to them. Red-green midrange? Yeah, I mean, this Blood Moon doesn't look very good. Snake Eyes, but, you know. Wow. 46% of bettors thought I was gonna win? Y'all are haters. Alright, running another prediction for the next match. Quick 1-0. Calls are sweet. Yeah, I kind of think they're good, like, because I just think, like, I don't want to play 5 Eternal Witnesses. I don't really want to play 4 Eternal Witnesses. But, you know, let's play card view. But, you know, that's how it is. All right, new prediction up for the next match. Get your bets in. No, I haven't, Titan. I probably won't have time to test it. I also don't know exactly how that should be built. Because it, like, requires you to play, like, a very stretched mana base. Like, you have to play, like, a lot of white sources, I think. Or maybe you just have to play more fetch lands. Like, you probably need even more fetch lands in that deck. Like, this already has 15, but you probably have to play, like, 16. But yeah, Brought Back is a pretty cool card. It's pretty interesting. Like, I wouldn't be surprised if it was good, you know? Alright. Gonna fire up the next match. Now that we have some bettors, feel free to get more bets in. So far, 5-1 with this list. Although there were some minor tweaks. Probably going to end up cutting this Abundant Harvest. I don't know, like... kind of wish I didn't have it, but I accidentally forgot to cut it for this week, so, you know, that's how it is, right? Reason for Knight. Thing is a good card to have access to, especially versus Blood Moon. It's kind of just, like, it's also life gain, it's also just, like, you know, it kills Urza Saga. I think it just does enough that you want it, right? Alright, opponent has no companion. Interesting. It's on the draw, I think I'm supposed to keep. I have two draws out of fetch, and then hand becomes really good. I have recycles with the Abundant Growths as well, so. Second island. Do I have two islands? Did I, like... I mean, I'm always open to reanalyzing the mana base, but... do I have two islands? Let me check real quick. Oh, I do. Maybe I shouldn't, actually. Okay, that's a fair point. I think the first island is good, though. Well, obviously the first island's good. It's just, like, the question is the second island good or not? Overgrown Tomb, so it's Yawgmoth, probably. Yeah, this is Yawgmoth. Land? Okay. I think I'm just going to play Wrenn and Six and shoot that. I'm gonna get green-white. Trying to get green white. Alright, there we go. Red, green. Depending on what they do next turn, like, I have a lot of options. But I generally feel comfortable in this matchup. Like, I don't think Yawgmoth actually lines up well versus a pile of Solitudes / Furies. Right, I especially don't care about that. I do care about that, unfortunately. Alright, that is not great for me, but whatever. I only have two cards in hand. But... Can we cool it with the ban announcements? Like, I don't think there were any ban announcements ever. If there actually was one, sure, but, you know. I'm actually gonna kill that, because I think it's kind of a pain in the ass. Oh, you know what? I should have just played one of the Abundant Growths first. That was a punt. I should have just played my land untapped, played Abundant Growth, then played the Prismatic Ending. God damn it, Caleb. Look, basically they're allowed to ban whenever they want. So, like, it's just people talking in the dark. It's like people trying to measure the Emperor's, the length of the Emperor's nose without having any real info. Yo, what's up, Matt? Both Matts. Alright, their hand, they literally just, this, they're hellbent now. This is great. Alright, so if I just draw mana sources and slash a little bit more action, I'll probably be okay. I guess that counts. God damn it, Matt. Alright, it's a weird-looking play, but it leaves you with optionality. Like, ooh, that's gonna be pretty good. I think I should just say go now. This also lets you get Abundant Growth into Graveyard for Eternal Witness if you want to go that route. But basically my best draw, I think, is Ephemerate here to just, like, wrath them. Because I think if I Furied all their stuff, they couldn't really win. That's five? Fine. I'll just see what I draw. Actually, maybe I want to get something. I do not think you can unban Summer Bloom, ever. The card's really powerful. Right, Eladomri's Call. Could just get Wandering Mind looking for Ephemerate, actually. But it's not a very good blocker otherwise. Kind of tricky. Alright, I think I'm actually supposed to get Eternal Witness. I have a plan. Alright, well, that's fine. Alright, that was really good. Okay, so now I'm just firing on all cylinders. I think I should just use the mana to cast Solitude on probably String Root Geist. I don't think the endurance actually matters whatsoever. Like, if you just take out their Undying Creatures, their deck doesn't really do that much as well. Omnath goes Burr indeed. I think, like, Omnath is just better than most of these decks by itself, which is kind of crazy to think about. Like, now they can't attack me, and I still have this behind, so it's, like, pretty hard for them to get through. So this means they have Yawgmoth. Oh no, I see. There's still Walk. I don't care. This is fine. I can witness back the Omnath. They know about the witness. It's face up. I just don't want to get punked out by, like, chip damage or whatever, you know? This forces out a court if they have one, or if they don't have one, so everything's face up. So, do I return one of their wall roots? No, that doesn't seem to do very much. I would just plus and put Yorion into my hand. And also attack for three. They can hit my Teferi for one damage, but I don't think that matters. I mean, they're flooding out, but I kind of feel like this happens to their deck a lot. It's just full of a lot of, like, mana dorks. Like, their best card is Yawgmoth. And the rest of their deck is, like, pretty manageable without Yawgmoth. Yawgmoth just Modern Alarin? Sort of, I guess. Hmm. Alright. Sure. I think I'm just gonna kill the Yawgmoth with the first activation on the stack. I mean, hypothetically, they can add... Oh, let's see. They have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So a chord for 1 is 4. Another chord for 1 is 4. So they could get 2 young wolves if they somehow... Oh, no, but they would have to... Yeah, no, it doesn't work. Also, why didn't they float green off their wall roots? Or did they float green? Oh, I guess they already floated green... Okay, yeah, that, never mind. They floated green, green, black, black. Right. I wonder if they should have sacrificed their ignoble hierarch, actually. Nah, I think modern, or I think Alurn is better than Yawgmoth is in modern, but, you know. I mean, kind of think all of the people who do well with Yawgmoth are really good players. So I think that's not a great sign for the deck. Like, Reed and Demonic Tutors are, like, pretty skilled pilots with the deck. And I don't really see other people do well with the deck, so... Alright, so they probably drew another Yawgmoth if this is what's going on. That's fine. I'll just kill the Yawgmoth with Fury. Like, basically, you just want to kill all of their Yawgmoths on sight. Well, they already floated mana, Matt. If they already floated mana, that means, like, it's not actually bugged for the chord. Like, they tapped... They used both Wallroot's Bird's Hierarch to cast Yawgmoth. No, the actual chord Wallroot's bugs is that the timing doesn't work right. Like, you should be able to use it to pay and tap when you're announcing a spell, but you can't. You have to float the mana first. And this bug has basically existed off and on since 2016, so, you know, kind of crazy, right? But... Just kind of bounce that. That's a really good draw, actually. So yeah, now I'm just going to play my... White, red, green, blue. I can leave up Counterspell, which is like kind of game-breaking. You think the bugs heard when he introduced colorless mana? Possibly. I don't know. So their hand is a young wolf and X. What this counterspell is just like kind of the hammer, the nail in the coffin. however you want to put it. Alright, that's fine. I'm only countering Yawgmoth or, like, Eldritch Evolution. Not really countering anything else. Obviously, Court of Calling for either of those things as well, so... This is a Court of Calling. See how they had to float mana first? I'm just slamming Counterspell, then I'm gonna witness back the Counterspell and, like, plus a Teferi, then it's just so hard for them to get out of this. I can Fury their whole board as well next turn, if that's good. I mean, there's a lot of things I can do, and they're mostly all pretty good. A fetch is... If I draw a fetch off this, it's just plus 5 mana, so... So, playing this and fetching with that is still plus mana, so now I'll do it. Yeah, I don't think they're ever fixing it, but it is a little bit annoying, you know? Matter. Nice. Alright. This one's mostly dead. And Glacial Worm Rex here. Yeah, that's still broken. Fair enough. Dryad Arbor. Okay. Can they really do much with that? I guess if they draw Yawgmoth, they can, like... Nah, they can't really do much still. And plus they drew a land, so... I think witnessing back a land might just be... Well, actually, I guess I'll just lead with this. Fetch is actually really good. I'll just reduce them to nothing. I'm gonna return Counterspell for sure. Alright, they've suffered enough misery, chat. They didn't want to suffer anymore. Bum, 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 bum. Oh, what a banger of a song. Chrono Trigger Medley by Tetramino. Urge. Bless are fine. Endurance is fine. Dress down's like okay, but not great. might still play it, I'm not sure. I think Knight of Autumn's pretty bad. Like, he doesn't do anything. What else should I cut? What else was I cutting on Monday? Does anyone remember? Anyone have suggestions? Anyone chat? I think maybe the dress downs are not good and the Teferis are not great. I actually changed my mind about dress down. So one good thing about dress down is that it can hypothetically shut off undying, but... Oh, I actually like Caesar some if you interfere with their mana dorks. I also just am loath to side out Spreading Seas a lot of the time, because I think your deck just needs the velocity. But I could also see cutting these versus them. I don't think Veil is actually very good versus them, for what it's worth. But also if you expect them to spam Thought Seizes, and I don't really. So the plan for Endurance is to just Endurance through Graveyard with Undying on the stack. Like, it can break up some weird stuff. Especially in combination with Fury. Like, if you Fury two Undying creatures, then Endurance them, they all get shuffled back. I mean, obviously that costs a lot of mana, but... Or it might cost zero mana, I guess, and just four cards. This is fine. The Button Harvest looking fine in this hand. Probably is worse than a fetch land still, but I'm definitely keeping this hand. Emrakul seems sweet. I don't think the games actually get to Emrakul, Matt. I think you only get to Emrakul them when you're already winning. I don't think that's actually how the matchup plays out, nor do you really need that, Matt. Needs an Emrakul? You're not wrong. I don't think really most people need an Emrakul. I think land is still best. Because I have a lot of spells in hand. Would have preferred to fetch, but whatever. I also want a pony, by the way. Yo, what's up, Mario? Played you earlier. You beat my face in. I also did mulligan a lot versus you, though, so... Fritz, Archer. Can I draw Ephemerate? Ephemerate would be so insane here. Yeah, I mean, I'm not even sure the matchup is that bad for you, but, you know. I still like the deck. I'm probably going to play it on Saturday if I have the time. I did play against two Rakdos decks and a Grixis shadow deck in that league. I went 2-1. I lost to the Grixis shadow deck and beat both of the Rakdos deck. Or sorry, one was Jund, one was Rakdos. But I kind of think we're heading in a direction where Veil of Summer is actually pretty good. So, like, I just can't imagine if you draw and resolve multiple Veils that you could ever lose. Oh yeah, the Mox Diamond's great. I'm pretty happy I picked it up. Obviously, there's a little bit of glare, but, you know. Mox Diamond is Mox Diamond. There's a Merit Wage on top, and the Pro Tour 25 playmat is over there. So, we got some bangers. Sure. I'll make them do all their stuff now. They should have actually attacked first, I think. But... because, like, now if you want to do all of your stuff, like... you give the 1 point of damage, which hypothetically could matter, you know? I think it's kind of a function of how many Veils they have as well. I think Veil is just so insane versus all of those decks that I think the more Veils you play, the worse it gets for all of the RBX sets. RBX lists. Alright, see, they're sacking stuff now, and it makes sense. I think counter, that's interesting. So I think what I would do is put a counter on that. It loses Undying and put a counter on that, I guess. You can also just not target anything, by the way. Like, it says up to. If you just want to sacrifice and cycle creatures besides itself, you're absolutely allowed to do so. Because my opponent's taking a while to figure out what to do. Alright, they just let it go. Interesting. That plan go for me. I'm gonna see what they do. I actually have a bunch of plays available. If they do nothing, I can just play Eldamri's Call, which is kind of nice. I actually think Call plays well with Aether Gust and Counterspell in a weird sort of way, because if they do nothing, you can always cast it. Like, you don't give up mana. And if they do something, like, then you can obviously Gust if you want to. Also, I should have just played the fetch, actually. And bluffed Counterspell even harder, but whatevs. Kind of hope they play Eldritch Evolution here. Because then, like, the Ghost beats them up pretty bad. So I won't allow it. So on my turn, I have a bunch of options again, but we'll see what happens. They put Grist on the bottom? Interesting. Okay. Sudden growth. Actually, I'm gonna do this. I don't have a second red source, so maybe I should have done it there, but... Okay. Do I just Fury them now? Let's see, 1, 2, 3... Yeah, I think I'm gonna Fury them. I'm giving up a lot of cardboard, but then I can call for Witness, and it kind of works itself out. I just want to constrain their resources. I'm actually going to go after the Wall of Roots and Ignoble Hierarch, I think. Because it makes Court of Calling a lot worse. I mean, I could, but I don't think that's necessary. I don't want to get so greedy that I'm behind by so much mana development. I guess I could also just... I could call for Omnath instead, I suppose, which is what you're proposing, right? Is that better than just, like, getting Witness, getting back Fury? What if I get Fury? Oh. Guess I'll look through my deck. And get whatever? Yeah, that's kind of where I'm at. I think Omnath might be actually be the best stabilization tool, because it's also the one that works the best with Yorion as well, and also gains a bunch of life. And it, if I just draw a fetch, I can just, like, do dumb stuff with Omnath, fetch, Yorion, flicker, everything. So, I guess I'll just get that. I'm just gonna go get one of the Triomes. I don't really want to draw. I should get Ragroon, I think, but it kind of is a wash anyways. Life matters a lot, actually. Four life basically stops their entire beatdown plan. No one can beat Oxon Hierarch. It's a lot better than Oxon Hierarch. Draw a card, make some mana, gain some life. All your fetch lands just, like, let you live forever. It's just, like, kind of an egregious magic card. And that's why I'm pro Eladomri's Call. Kind of, because, like, it lets you play these... It effectively lets you play more copies of Omnath, right? Did I miss out on 4 mana? Tell me how I should have sequenced that, Matt. Doesn't it have to see every single land? I'm pretty sure it has to see the lands, so I don't think I did. Yeah, that's what I thought, Matt! That's what I thought! Alright, let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6... Plus 4, that's 10. That's a lot of mana. But this is kind of game-breaking, because I also have Counterspell backup for all of this, I'm pretty sure. Doesn't matter what land I get. Probably... not? No, I'm not gonna do that. I think I have a better line, Matt. Just gonna put Yori onto my hand, cast it, and leave up Counterspell mana. Imagine that. I can't imagine it. I don't think that exists. So I can Flicker Abundant Growth, Omnath, Spreading Seeds, so that's just Tidings. Or just Concentrate, attached to a 4-5 flyer. I guess the shields are down for exactly 1 second, but that's okay. Durion's so insane in this deck. Like, this is... Someone was asking about Kahira versus Yorion, but Yorion is just so much better. Like, it's kind of crazy. You can cast a Chord for 2. I don't think that does much. I guess if they have, like, Containment Priest, I might get caught, but, like, it's not even that bad for me, right? Main deck off color. Well, this is a sideboard game, so, like, I don't know, people do all sorts of weird stuff is how I would put it, you know? Nothing stops them from actually putting Containment Priest in their deck, even though it's, like, not very good in their deck, so. You never know. Also, I've seen so much weird shit happen in my years of playing MTGO. Ancient Grudge in your Living End sideboard? Yeah, I wouldn't recommend that. I assume you had Cascade spells in your deck. In which case, the issue is you will Cascade into that. Yeah, we are not about that. Finalists of 100% FNM? Well, that's awkward. Let's see. How do I want to proceed? At minimum, I can always witness back Counterspell. This is pretty good still. To do is use the Omnath mana to cast that. Alright, hit you for 8. Half Counterspell up. Good luck. Why? I'm pretty sure E-Witting Fury is actually E-Witting Counterspell. This protects you from Yawgmoth. Like, Fury doesn't protect you from Yawgmoth. Dementia. I care. No. Alright, they'll name Counterspell. That's fine. They'll also probably time out. Because I'm ahead by 5 minutes or whatever. 5.5 minutes, approximately. Sure, you got my Counterspells. Free zombie? Yep. It is a free zombie. Free zomboid. Friend of mine used to call zombies zomboners, but that's just kind of weird. Alright, did they get all my counterspells? They did. They can also see my deck, but it doesn't really matter. Oh, well, I see. So if I ephemerate that, yeah, that's just like everything's gone now. Do I get Fury? Hopefully. This 2/2 use random minus and everything's dead. No, I don't think you need ephemerate Yorion. I actually just want to attack them with the rest of my creatures. You do 2/2, subtract one there, then you attack for 10, and then like they're just drawing dead. I mean, they were mostly drawing dead, so. Alright, 2-0 so far. I'm currently 6-1 with this list. Anyways, thanks for everyone being here. If you want to support the stream, hit that follow button. That's free to do. If you have a Twitch Prime or regular sub you want to use here, please consider using it. At least check for it. You can see why winning would be better than me. I already had all the value I needed. Like, I could just pick up the ephemerate. Yo, big take 10. Was that you, C. Strollo? Yeah, I kind of just had it all versus you, it felt like. But I also think that matchup is good for 4C. Specifically, if you have Eldar Armory's Call in your deck, I think it's pretty good. I see. Fair enough. Might check it out afterwards. Alright. Gonna get some Waterbeard back for round 3. Yo, thanks, Regis Jr. 81. 12 months. Thank you so much. We are back for round 3. Get your bets in on the channel points. Yo, I'm back. Regis Jr. also let me know if I should open a chest for you. I assume the answer is yes, but Yes? Alright. Let's open that chest for Regis Jr. 81. Let's see what's inside it. Grafted Identity. And 15 play points. Not a great chest, but... This is from AF... No, this is from Innistrad and Midnight Hunt. I can never remember what cards... What sets new cards are from, because there's just so many sets nowadays. Alright. Let's go back and play the third match. What's up, Ryan? Hope you're having a good one. There's only like 100 sets. It's really less than 100. Being anxious about an interview? Well, good luck. Hope you get what you want. Demonic tutors and aspiring by crushing the trophy race. Misplaced Ginger in third. Yeah, I saw that, Mephistopheles. You were working on a proxy gauntlet and ran out basic force. The four sets a year thing did not hold true for these past few years, I think. Against Ben is so pretty. Wow, if there's anyone named Ben in the chat, apparently you're so pretty. Alright, opponent has Luris, so that means I'm gonna keep any reasonable 7, and this is a reasonable 7, so. I'm not gonna Fury it. I'm gonna hope they play another creature. Obviously, this might bite me in the butt, but... Once up Teeth and Counterspell seem wrong to you? Well, there's Breeding Pool and Alathon in my deck, so... You know... I don't know what you want from me there. Right, they hit Misty Rainforest, that's fine. Alright. Alright, chat. No, chat! Chat, my everything! I was gonna get them so good. Oh, they took that? So now if I draw another red card... Card, please. I think not taking Fury is a mistake, yeah. Alright, well, nice. I get to punish them. They definitely should have taken Fury. Like, it's just so greedy not to. Put Loris in hand, that's fine. They can't even castle Loris because of Spreading Seas. That's kind of sick. Just trying to elongate the game. But the Fury thing worked out well for me. Like, they... Their play was so maniacal, in my opinion. Spring Seas is basically like cantrips and coal versus them. Alright, well, we're in really good shape. They wanted to greed me out, but yeah, I think you should just make the safe. Like, they could have beaten me pretty easily if I just didn't have Fury in my hand, you know? Like, it just doesn't make any sense. Alright, good luck. That's all I got. That's all I got. Spring Seas is just so insane versus these decks, like... yeah, I want to get a land back, I think. Let them resolve the surveil. Chinka. Considering if I didn't need to do it, but... Rakdos... Why do people love this Rakdos deck? It's like kind of baffling to me. Or I guess I don't like the Rakdos deck, is how I should put it. Looks like an Izzet deck. It's definitely Grixis. Iterationless Grixis. Alright, this is not necessary. Fairies are not great. I was signing in Gus versus Rakdos, but not Grixis, and I think that makes sense. And I think, oh wait, I want all my veils. I think I'm just gonna take out Counterspell. That's what I decided in this matchup. I just would rather veil their discard. And like Counterspell's like not great. I may have even won. I mean, obviously Counterspell was pretty insane that game, but I think generally that's not what happens a lot of the time. Last card could be the one Teferi, one Counterspell. Probably a Counterspell is better on average. It's kind of close. I guess Teferi pitches to Solitude, so maybe that's actually the deal breaker. Knight of Autumn pitches to both Solitude and Endurance. Maybe that's actually better. Well, this card's like kind of mopey, so. We'll try this. This song's really good. Alright, keep. Has 7 cards, is reasonable, keep. There are times, like, if they have Lurrus plus Bauble and you don't have, like, an answer to the Lurrus, you probably should just Endurance them. But also, I think the card's just fine as a blocker as well, because the matchup is about them trying to kill you, rather than anything else. Yo, Chili S, welcome back. Thank you for the resub. Gonna name land here for sure. Alright, I was kind of afraid I would get the second island, but whatever. Sand's fine now. Drinking some refreshing milk and yogurt flavor soda. It's Korean style. Really delicious. No, it's actually really good, but, you know, whatever, John. Alright, just gonna kill all of their stuff. We'll Spreading Seas later. Oh, nice. They don't have anything? Love to see it. They didn't even put that into their hand? So what does that mean? Means I want to see go, I think. Kind of interesting they didn't put the Lurrus into their hand. So are they gonna K command me? Like, it doesn't even seem very good. Okay. This does not seem like something I would recommend doing. Yeah, and then, I mean, it's the Ephemerate or the P ending. It might actually be the P ending, honestly. I can also discard Spreading Seas. I kind of think it's not going to be great this game. So I'm going to actually discard the Seas. But that was just discard one, make me shock me. Like, this is worse than Blightning if you're going to use it that way. So I don't really think that's what you want, you know? Gonna target them. Because they have crooks in their decks, you might as well cut out of their graveyard. I'll let them kill my creatures if they want. I'm just gonna fetch up a basic now. Actually, maybe I should fetch up Sacred Foundry. It's my second red and second white. Yeah, I should get Sacred Foundry. I'm missing blue, but that's fine. I sided out all my counter spells, so. Alright, it's fine. Yep. Yeah. Between Kroxa and Ragavan, those decks play Shinka and Chizo, John. I think Chizo's actually the better of the two, personally. But Chizo plus Ragavan's actually kind of sick, you know? Okay. They just play one of each. It's not a big deal, I think. I'm really looking for Fury now, I guess. I think I should just main phase cycle.
new phase cycle. Working it out.
Oh, shoot. Maybe I shouldn't. Okay. I guess I probably shouldn't have then. But 1, 2, 4. That's 7. I'm actually just gonna say go and pump the brakes. I probably shouldn't have cycled, actually. I forgot about that for a second, but it ended up okay. I mean, next turn I'm gonna have a banana's turn, so it's fine. Yeah, Den is one of the most expensive cards. It's just seeing you play in a lot of formats, personally. Alright. Interesting. It's fine. Choking Sands? Oh, Maria. You should check e-price. It's like 34 tickets on MTGO the last time I checked. Or I guess you can double check me, but I'm pretty sure it's that much. Does it matter? It might, but I don't think my life total actually matters. Was I right? Oh, it's 41 now. It's because AFR was not heavily drafted, I think. This is kind of like a KO. I'm just having fun dirtling, personally. Wrenn's not bad. Yeah, it's the only playable rare in the whole economy. Alright, so they still have Loris in their hand, right? I didn't actually ever kill the Loris, but that's fine. Probably we'll be able to just, like, you know, keep up because I'm, like, I have a huge mana advantage. I can, like, loop a lot of shit. That's good too. I mean, I guess I don't literally have them dead, but it feels like they're mostly dead, so. I mean, yeah, this bumps your thing, but I don't think that actually matters anymore. Hold on, Respawn. I can trade these off, and that's like, oh no, then they could hypothetically cast it re-kicked. They have a swamp. So I probably shouldn't attack that one. We'll just attack with this one. It's probably a free roll, but I think we're in garbage mode again. Garbage time. Yeah, it could, but, like, I could just sit here and then watch them lose to my card advantage. So that's kind of more fun, personally. I don't really care if they just, like, bobble me twice per turn. Like, that doesn't really matter. Like, their two cards is worse than my infinity cards per turn, right? Look at all these zones. Yeah. I can close this one, actually. Good call, John. I can close that zone. Okay. I think they're kind of screwed. Like, they can take a card, and I don't really care which one they take. It doesn't really matter. I believe that Ephemerate is still... Yeah, it's... I'm still gonna Ephemerate... then. I think it'll just let the Wrenn die if they attack it, personally. Like... how does it do versus burn? You're probably a little bit soft, but it's not... I mean, if I wanted to improve the burn matchup, it would be relatively easy to do so. Oh, I forgot to cast that. Whoops. God damn it. Not paying attention. Eh, whatever. This is still fine. I mean, I have so much mana. Alright, that's like a good insurance policy. What happens if I just get... I guess I should just get Fury and pick up a land and not risk anything. Gets forest. So, they're basically dead again, which is kind of nice. But all the games basically end the same way. You just, like, snowball way out of control. Right. And I'm going to just get their graveyard. Just in case. And I think the Gust is kind of, like, nice insurance, even though I don't think Gust is incredible versus them. Like, this is a matchup where I'd rather have Celestial Purge. So I've Gust pretty much most of the time, but I think there's enough cards that it interacts with, like Kroxa, all of the early creatures, that I think Gust is still worth having in. And K-Command. Like, Gustin and K-Command's kind of okay.
Okay. That's less okay, I guess.
I mean, they're also at 5, and I have 3 creatures that have 3 power or more, so it's kind of a bad situation for them. Also, I could just do this. They block here and here. Then, like, even if they fetch, like, I have 2 lethal attackers, so it doesn't really work. I could also just ping them 2 more times, and, like, it super works. Ding! Fries are done. Kind of just had it all that game, but that's how it is a lot of these games. You just, like, end up so much stuff that they can never win, you know? Alright, prediction for the 4th match. Wait, I want fries? Well, you can have fries if you gift more subs to the channel, or if you get people to sub. Speaking of which, if you're new to the stream, hit that follow button, that's free to do. If you really want to support the stream, check for your Twitch Prime sub or regular sub, and it's greatly appreciated here, and they're awesome emotes, you know? Yeah, like those. Anyways, get your bets in. I'm waiting a few seconds to get the bets in before you will see my opening hand. But keep in mind, I am currently 7-1 with this deck in leagues, and I've played mostly real matchups, I think. So, kind of a good sign for the deck. Not sure about this Wandering Mind still, obviously. Like, kind of hard to tell if it's good or not. I think the cards that I'm least sure about are Abundant Harvest, Wandering Mind, Where the Night of Autumn Should Be, the exact sideboard is exactly okay. Yeah, probably. I think 4 Veil, 2 Veto, a Purge, and 2 Gust felt pretty good. You might want to go 2 Purge, 1 Gust, I'm not sure. Like, kind of coin flippy, you know? We need some no-betters if you want that bet to fire. Some people have to disbelieve. Plus, you're getting pretty good odds if you bet no. So. You need a doubter? Alright, we got some doubters. Okay. Let's go into the queue. Big money in Descent. Yeah, there is actually pretty big money in Descent, yeah. Chloris. Probably can't keep this one, though. This is exactly fine. This island's awkward, but I'm not mulliganing. Get out. I don't want that to happen to me. Can't be better than 3-1 versus a random opponent. Alright, I mean, whatever you want, I suppose. I don't have, like, actual Emerald Cooldowns stored, but I have a second Endurance. I can Eld Armory's Call for Endurance as well to shuffle itself back in. So, Stone of Ruin, huh? Oh, weird. It's Azorius Mill instead of Dimir. Deckwood I have not personally, but that sounds weird. Got me. Alright. There you go. I'm gonna Eld Armory's Call for Eternal Witness, I think, just to pick up a land. No, I understand you, Swan Daddy. That's fine. I understand where you're at completely. Yeah, I mean, like, I don't think actually adding 20 cards does very much, if that's what you're asking. I mean, if they only draw, like, burn spells, essentially, like, these are burn spells. If they only draw burn spells, then obviously it matters, but I think generally it doesn't actually matter that much. My plan is to kill all of their, Watscour, huh? My plan is to kill all of their, like, mill crabs. What about 160? I think, like, they could easily beat you. Still.
My endurance is still in the deck, so that's good to know. My plan is, in fact, to witness back endurance, yeah. Giving them land kind of sucks, especially if, since it's, like, probably a plains. Oh, do they not have? I guess they only have two Hallowed Fountains? What's going on? Sigh. It's really depressing. Basically just lost to a bunch of blue burn spells. I know, but this is lethal. I needed one more turn to set that up. I've heard this matchup isn't good, and I'm inclined to agree, but, you know, at least we have a plan. That sucks. I don't think those are great, actually. I think probably my next worst card is... This is not great. Well... Emrakul with Aeon's Torrent is better than Wheel of Sun and Moon in this deck, Swan Daddy. So, if I wanted a hammer, that's the hammer I would play. I think I'm gonna just cut Wandering Mind. To be fair. I think it's not great. Anyways, that was a frustrating game, but, you know, sometimes it happens. They played an Ancestral Recall. Visions of Beyond is really good in their deck. I didn't even really let them keep crabs for more than a turn cycle, so it's like they only got chip damage in with those. Never cool. Maybe I'm actually supposed to keep this. Yeah, I think I actually am. Just kind of funny to look at, but I can turbo out that Emrakul if the Archive trapped me a bunch of times. So. Actually, I should fetch now because they can only get one Archive Trap. If they have one. If they top deck another, then, like, if you wait to fetch, they get to fire off more. Sting? Okay. Sculptor. Five types. What am I missing? Creatures somehow? I am missing creature, right? You never like the Promise End? I mean, it's not really specifically for this matchup, but, you know, it's fine. Okay. If I draw... I wonder if I even have fetchables left, but... Maybe I'm supposed to just endurance myself. I'm supposed to. I mean, I could have, like, actually Emrakuled them if I'd drawn a fetch, but whatever. I think I'm supposed to just endurance myself. The ruin grabs an O3, so it doesn't really accomplish very much, in my opinion. I mean, I guess you could bluff, but it doesn't really matter. They could play around Wrenn 6. Oh, you're right. Okay. I'm just trying not to time out. You're right that I should be bluffing, but what if they have Fallen Shinobi? Alright, they conceded to the Ephemerate Endurance loop. Kinda sick. Alright. Don't wanna change anything. But I do want Path in my deck just for the freaking Mill Crabs. Let me actually check the Azorius list out. No, I refuse. I don't want to lose to Fallen Shinobi. I refuse! Mill. I need to find a Azorius Mill. Where the hell is Azorius Mill? Oh, F Mill. Where is the Azorius Mill deck? Alright, Azorius Mill, Garrick 911. I think I found it. Cut one Fury, I think. Kind of tough to figure out what I should cut, but I think Fury is the right cut, actually. The reason I think Fury is correct is that I think I have a lot more white cards than red cards. And it's not likely I would get the 2-for-1 off Fury anyways. It would literally have to be like Lurrus plus an O2 crab or two O2 crabs. Okay, this is fine. Sided out of Lurrus. That means Ashiok, probably, given the list I looked at. Ashiok archetype trap combo. You know it. Okay. Okay, it's a little bit irritating, but whatever. Okay. Carry themselves? I think that's correct, really, but I Okay. Oh, Jason, sorry. I'm on MTGO. Sorry about that. I should have cross-stepped actor thing, but whatever. It's fine. Anyways, what's up, Jason? Jace's Phantasm? I do not think I will lose to Jace's Phantasm this game, personally. I have a really shit plan. It's to use Solitude to ambush the Ashiok and hope they don't have anything else. Zemrakul is kind of off the table, unfortunately, but whatever. Mm-hmm. So I have an Endurance and two Old Armory's Calls left. Draw two. Ooh, they cycled their thing. That's good for me. Nice. Oh, not Kyle. That's nice. Oh wait, is 20 or less? Still safe then, I guess. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Oh shoot. I was supposed to... Oh. That was a mistake. Okay, I'm not sure it actually cost me, but... Should have thought it all the way through. A fetchable left? I think there is. Am I conceding? Interesting. I think I have fetchables left, but I guess I can draw my entire deck. Find out. Old Army's Call, Teferi. Old Army's Call, I think, wins the game because I just go get Endurance. Are there fetchables left? There's a Plains left, but that doesn't fetch Plains. Maybe there isn't. Maybe there is no fetchable left. Old Army's Call. I think they have all remands, probably basic swamps, if I had to guess. All remands and spell pierces. I can't draw anymore, Louie. It bugged out. I don't know. I think I have vegetables left, but, you know. I literally can't tell anymore, though. So, MT Joe decided to stop letting me draw cards. Alright, okay, running another prediction for the last match of the night. If you're new here, hit that follow button, that's appreciated, that's free to do. If you really want to support the stream and you have a Twitch Prime or regular sub, please check for it and consider using it here. Trophy time? Yeah. Will I win this match for the trophy? Get your bets in. This deck's really strong, obviously, like... I mean, it's just a pile of good cards. Okay. Okay, I'm supposed to message Jason Ford on his MDGO account real quick. So, wait, did my MTGO crash? Maybe it did. Alright, let's see what happens. Yep, quality. Yep. If it crashed, we don't have to message? Well, I messaged. Okay, what is happening? What? Okay. Are these mine? I'm confused. Am I literally taking everything? I'm so confused. I don't know what's happening. Okay, ticks too. Alright, whatever. I don't know what's going on. Okay. Apparently I'm taking everything, I don't know why. Okay, I mean, that's another way to support this stream. If you want to quit MTGO and just open trade and give me stuff, that is also appreciated. Round one. Shout out to J4. Oh, look at this chest! I opened up 4 Cavern Souls, 134 tickets, Oath, Oath of the Gatewatch pack, 3 Fate Reforged packs, and 2 Dominaria packs. So, basically, open the packs. One sec. We're checking something before we open these packs. Dominaria booster pack. A Dominaria booster pack is 36 cents. Alright, we'll open the Dominaria packs. I can't wait for more garbage on my account. Oh, is this worth anything? This is almost worth as much as the pack. That's hilarious. Alright, another Dominaria pack. Is this worth anything? Probably not. No. That's somehow worth way less. Alright. Oath of the Gatewatch booster. Booster pack. 90 cents! Alright, we'll open it anyways. 90 cents is like nothing. Oath of Chandra, is that worth anything? I also purge a lot of things. Or I move them to a mule account. Alright, that's 1 cent. Great. Alright, how about these favorite forge packs? What do we think? Booster pack. 81 cents? Alright, whatever. We're just opening everything that Jason sent us. Citadel Siege. This was like one of the best rares to open in that format. Just actually unbeatable. Give you a hint, you should pick cons and your opponent dies. Dragonscale General, also unbeatable. You just like, you know, you sneak in with your, like, one evasive creature, and that's, like, a smaller Citadel Siege, and if you sneak in two, it's, like, actual Citadel Siege at your end step. I missed the big money at the end? Maybe. Alright. One last Fate Reforged pack. Mardu Strike Leader. That ain't it. Alright, whatever. 1/3 of the rares in Fate Reforged were unbeatable. Maybe 1/2? But it was an enormous number. Alright. Anyways, last match for the night. Get your bets in. If you want. Or maybe the bets are gone. What if the Citadel Siege was a 4/6 hex with Hexproof and Green? No, they were unbeatable, Ultimate Price, trust me. Alright, we got a match. We're playing against Radiant Rice. They were Demir Mill 5 days ago, but that doesn't mean anything. It could literally be anything now. Alright, well, this hand's pretty good. I just hope they aren't mill, obviously, because I think the same thing would happen, but, you know. Well, I got lucky in the game 3 versus mill, I think, but I think generally it's not a great matchup. I mean, I would... Looks like... Fuck me. Yo, what's up, Adam? Hope you're having a good one. All right. What's with all the mill decks? Well, I'm fetching anyways. I really need to get Robber and Triumph, so... Alright. Like, the problem is, like, you're actually really slow. I mean... You're not actually good at killing the mill decks, so it's pretty easy for them to just mill you out. Like, I don't actually think it's that funny. Like, I don't think the matchup's good. Ooh, if they miss their land drop, though. I don't even want a Spreading Seas that. Time for Wandering Mind. I like this card. Look at the art. It's kind of goofy looking. Oh, we bricked. That sucks. Note you can hit Planeswalkers or Abundant Growths, so like it's actually not that likely to miss, but you know, whatevs. Six, yeah, something like that. What's going on? Are they surgicaling my counterspells? Sure. Fine. I don't really care. The card I wanted to draw the most is actually Elodomri's Call to go get Endurance and just stack it so you can shuffle the Endurance and itself back in. This storm deck looks terrible. What storm deck? I don't see a storm deck. Shell Dock. I wish I had my Spreading Seas back. This. Oops. Just want to get a clock on them. If they've drawn the lock, fine, whatever. Yeah, Wrenn and Six is not that cheap, although it's lower than it used to be, I think. Alright. trying to kill them, so at least there's... Okay, well, I guess there goes my clock. But I guess I can play a 4-3 now. Or send to their hand, fine. Four, three, get in there. All right, this is all I got. They can lure us back their crab, I guess, but you know, that's fine. How have I been? I'm exactly okay. Oh, I see. I didn't actually know what you were referring to. Yeah, this is a bad storm deck, though. I honestly had no idea what you were talking about. I didn't really take offense, I was just more confused, you know? I've been watching a little bit of it, yeah, Nevisdorth, and also the Speed Chess Championship. It's pretty interesting. No. Yeah, I guess you got that too. Okay. What did it get? Did it get my Endurance? Did not, thankfully. Shooting them, I think, is really key, because it puts them to 5, then I can shoot them and attack them with Yorion. No, I... Bride the Fry Guy, I don't think that's actually a big issue for the deck. It obviously, like... I don't think you want to draw too many of the burn spells, quote-unquote. I think what you want to draw are the crabs, essentially. If you draw a lot of crabs, like... You can kind of overcome it, but this person didn't have a smooth draw this game, and it's still kind of close. Anyways, I move the Seas over to the Sheldrake Isle, obviously. It just makes so much sense. Yeah, I mean, Tasha's Hideous Laughter is not good in this matchup, but besides that, you know, things are kind of not that bad for them, honestly. What is this, a Fatal Push or a Surgical? I mean, Fatal Push does literally nothing. Okay. I don't really need Ephemerate anymore. I mean, I guess they might kill with Drown the Lock, whatever, but... Okay. There goes my endurance, but hopefully they're dead. 4 plus 1 is 5. Cleverly moved the Spreading Seas over, and they only have 2 mana. Nice! Right. Right. Wait. Alright, that's one way to do it, I guess. Like, I don't know. I kind of just killed them with my creatures, which can happen, but Veil was a lot better in this matchup. What else was I cutting? I think Spreading Seas is actually good for Shelduck Isle, so I should keep it. Wrenn's good. Maybe I don't need Ephemerate, actually, but Ephemerate plus Endurance is really strong. So I'm not sure. Oh, also, I don't have Emrakulin. Maybe it is Spreading Seas. Alright, I guess it is Spreading Seas. Are there other cards with names like... I mean, there's Slaughter Games. There's Tooth of Slaughter. There's Slaughter Specialist. There's Mogus God of Slaughter. Should I keep going, or are we done? No, they don't play Mesmeric Orb. That's, like, antiquated. I mean, obviously people could play Mesmeric Orb, but I think people generally don't. Okay. I think this is more Slaughter, please. Well, I'll name more Slaughters if people sub, otherwise I'm not naming more Slaughters. This hand's pretty good. I mean, it's missing a clock. This one is to mess with a guy named Steve North. Yeah, Slaughter's a card. It's a buyback terror, essentially, from Exodus. Yo, Janky, thank you so much. Oh, I need to name more Slaughters for you? Alright. Give me a sec while I figure out what to fetch, but this is probably Breeding Pool. Slaughter, Slaughter, Slaughter. There's like Forerunner Slaughter, there's Gruesome Slaughter. There's a bunch, I don't know, like... There's, like, literally a shit ton. Cool. Okay. Wait, where's my health on? Oh, it's in my hand. Shit. Probably was supposed to play around that somehow. Margarin Trium it is. Slaughter Pack, sure. There's also Slaughterhorn from Gatecrash. Oh, I was probably supposed to veil that. Whoops. I'm just not paying attention. Fuck. I definitely was supposed to veil that. Alright, well. Also, if I just paid attention and played Hallowed Fountain, I think it would have been better for me as well. So. Should probably target the Endurance. What are Foothills? Okay. Interesting. Fuck. Everything turned out poorly. If I just played Hallowed Fountain, I'd be so much better off. A lot of Soul-Eye Lanterns. Get slaughtered. Hopefully not. I'm pretty sure I named a bunch of those Aquinas 9, but not all of them, obviously. Also, Janky, should I open a chest for you after this? God, if I didn't give them a free Ancestral, I don't know how this game would look, but I could have played around it. I'm kind of tilted. Some of the strong gatherer skills? They're down to one card, but unfortunately they are dinging me for six a turn. Alright, Horus is in their hand. No, it's not Legacy. Doesn't it say Modern or see Moneyball Pile at the bottom, Omnivian? Bye? Okay, bye. I mean, I don't think I was tricking anyone by saying what I was playing. That's really weird. Moneyball is a nice movie, it's one of my faves. They lose at the end? Who's they? I don't really like baseball, but I do like that movie. I mean, I think baseball's like pretty boring to watch, honestly, but you know, whatevs. Yeah, I think they lose like in the playoffs or whatever, but that's like kind of beside the point, I think. There are a lot of numbers, but, like, you know. One card. Okay. World Series. All right, fair enough. So you can veil Hedron Crab, but you cannot veil Ruin Crab. So there's actually another difference. So you can buy turns by veiling those activations, I think. Each opponent. Okay, alright. I'm down to 3 cards. Alright, I can't win. I was hoping it wasn't Tasha's, but... It was Tasha's. Alright, game 3 versus Bubak Mel. Never go, trust your instincts. Yeah, their wins per money ratio was insane. That's the Moneyball part of that movie. Yeah, just submit and hope it goes better. I think if I played Hallowed Fountain that game on turn 2, I'd be so much better off. But I fucked it up. Um, 84. I don't know, like, you could, but there's already an issue drawing enough and the right number of lands. Well, the sand's fantastic, so whatever. Wonder to Rook. Oh yeah, I played a bunch of Blitz recently as well. I'm so rusty at Blitz. I also am not, like, very good at chess anymore. Like, it's probably debatable if I ever was, but certainly not now, because, like, I don't really play enough to be where I want to be for that game. This is actually a good draw, but we'll see what happens. Need to get something that casts. Please, Steam Vents is best. Well, I don't have Fury in my deck, actually, so that's wrong. I should have just gotten Breeding Pool, I think. But whatever. Jarvis vs. Magnus, let's go. A friend of mine said, how could it be the World Championship if he wasn't invited? And I thought that was pretty funny, actually. It was, Jorbs, aka Join Ribs. It's clearly not the World Championship if he wasn't invited. You take me versus Ved? I don't know. Ask Ved about that. I literally don't know. There's a Soul Guide now. Okay. Well, I guess what I'm gonna do is try to pick up my fetch, see if it works. Okay. Bulldog. Because it might got lost in the mail. Probably. I mean, they're not just like pieces of candy for everyone to have. You gotta work for them, you know? You really gotta work for them. Yeah, that's the plan, but I mean, it's kind of hard to, like, get them to do it, you know? You sometimes can mize them with Emrakul as well, but it really depends. Like, I don't think this person's going to do it blind, obviously, but it's definitely possible. Stan? I'm not sure. I think so, but I also am not sure. That's kind of interesting. Maybe I should just ping it twice. Probably should. Like, I basically have enough lands that this is fine to do. Don't even really care. Sure, that's fine. Okay. I think I'm actually going to take Veto, I think. So I don't think this is really that problematic. Whereas, like, I think the Veto is pretty valuable. I'm actually afraid of, like, losing all my vegetables, which is, like, kind of ridiculous to say, but it actually, I think, is a big deal. What card type am I missing? Sorcery, I guess? Got him, chat. Got him. You've cracked your thing. We got him, chat. We got him. So they might crack their Soul Guide in response, then I can Endurance myself pitching Veil. 5-0 hype with Emrakul. Yeah. I mean, it kind of feels like it. Like, they have to crack the Lantern. Otherwise, I just, like, make them draw a card and, like, do stuff to them. Wait, oh, they counterspelled the Emrakul! Kappa! Nice! Got him, chat! Got him! Final hype! Can't believe that happened. Can't believe that happened. G, yeah. Alright. I'm not competing in the trophy race. Can't believe I beat Mill 2-0 that time. Or 2-1. Which game did I lose? Game 2 because I punted? God, that's so insane. Take that, Storm. Open all chests? We only open chests if people sub. Matt. Or not Matt. Andrew. Am I the trophy leader? Probably not. Am I going to play this deck on Saturday? Probably. Grateful Head, I have no idea. You can go to their website and check. But I don't work for them anymore, so... Am I going to MTG first thing? No, I'm going to play the Mox on MTGO. I would probably play this deck IRL, but I lent Dave a bunch of my cards as well. So I'm not. Alright, Alright. I think I'm done for now. I'll be back tomorrow with Dom to go over a good vintage result of his, and we can just talk about vintage tomorrow. But I think I'm going to call it for now. Thanks for being here. If you want to support the stream, you know how. That follow button, check out the coaching links, consider using your Twitch Prime sub, you know. Everything is appreciated, but stick around for the raid. We're going to give Sneaky Masato some support, aka Kane Reinhard. Fan of his stream, he's pretty chill, and, you know, he's also playing 4C, so check it out.